Hello, my mathematicians. Today we are looking at Module 20, Lesson 1, which is all about identifying and classifying polygons. Hopefully, by the end of this lesson, you'll be able to identify and classify polygons. So, spark your learning. Many of the figures found in art, nature, and science are familiar. Group the polygons shown based on two or more features or attributes that they have in common. So, we're going to make a Venn diagram. Don't mind my rough finishing there of the circles, but okay. So we're gonna put triangles in one there are several of those. We're gonna put some of the shapes have at least one right triangle or angle. And sides are all the same length. So we look up here. This shape here does not have all the sides the same length. We can tell that because there's only two marks and none of them are right angles. So it's just going to go here. The next one also doesn't have them all the same rate, but it is a triangle, so then our shape here, the square, has sides that are all the same length and has at least one right triangle. So it's gonna go here, a right angle. I don't know why I keep saying triangle. And then we have a triangle with at least one right angle, but it does not have all the sides the same. So we're going to put it here. Here we have a triangle that has all the sides that are the same. Here we have a shape that has at least one right angle, it's not a triangle, it does not have all the sides that are the same. Here, not all the sides are the same, but it has at least one right angle. Then our last shape, all the sides are the same, but it does not have right angles and it's not a triangle. And that it's not drawn very well, but that is why we put the line so that we know what we mean. Everything is the same. Mr. Berger and his class are looking at the polygon shown. Record the attributes of the different polygons in the table. Complete the column for the figure that has seven vertices. Draw the column for an octagon. or complete the column for nonagon, draw two other polygons and complete the columns. Well, so this here has seven sides. A seven-sided figure, if I scroll, says this down here says the prefix hepta is Greek for the number seven. So a heptagon is a polygon with seven sides. The prefix nona is Latin for the number nine, so a nonagon is a number with nine sides. So the prefix of this, or the name of this, is heptagon. Because there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 sides, 7 angles, and 7 vertices. Nonagon, it says, has 9 sides. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So there's 9 angles, 9 vertices. So we can look at a pentagon next. The pentagon has 5 sides. So that's 5 angles, 5 vertices. We can do a hexagon. These are irregular shapes here. But hexagon, because we have 6 sides, 6 angles, 6 vertices. So what do you notice about the attributes of each polygon? Well, for each polygon, the numbers of sides angles and vertices are the same. So, Mr. Berger drew these polygons on the whiteboard. It says, well, first let's connect to the vocabulary. So, the word congruent describes equal angle measures or equal side lengths in a figure. A regular polygon is a polygon in which all sides are congruent and all angles are congruent. So, what do you notice about the attributes of the polygons in group one? Well, they seem to have side lengths that are the same and angles that are the same. So all side length and angle measures appear to be the same. What do you notice about the attributes of the polygons in group two? Well, the side lengths and angle measures do not appear to be the same. So describe both groups of polygons using the words congruent and regular. So the polygons in group one appear to be regular polygons because there are sides and angles are congruent. Group two. Group two sides and angles are not congruent. So they are not regular polygons. And that is all for today's lesson. Hopefully, you are now able to identify and classify polygons. And remember, in order to be a math person, all you have to do is be a person and do math.